both were right, that's phenomenal. Could have said American, maybe that may have been whatever surprise that was.
And Patrick in the district, Huntsville, where his independent game is also one that opened that large chunk of people in the kingdom of Michael Brown. I said, maybe the difference was that. And the difference was that this race really became about Michael Brown's personal and financial issues that he was having. And he came in and lost more than $50,000, which is still being looked at by the authorities. And that is a particularly problematic for them because they're accepting the fear of problems with these people. They're also doing the same thing. The fact that they have no money left to do. And his opponent, David Costa, was able to be a fundraiser and sent down after the 3 or 4 Mariners lost people in the final days. And that really was, I think, what made the difference.
What's ahead now from yesterday? And Michael, look at these Democratic wins both on the statewide level. We also had some Democratic wins in Alexandria as well. What does this mean for Virginia politics moving forward?
It means that Virginia has cemented a place for itself as a swing state. If you look at 2009 election, Governor McDonald won for Andy Vickery. And then just last year, we were talking about Republicans taking control of the state Senate. And now we're talking about Romney and Haynes. So it's really definitely a swing state. Even if you look at some of these important women Virginia jurisdictions, Fairfax, Kingsbury, and Loudoun all voted for McDonald in 2009, and they won the Obama district.
And there's also some of the extensions going to it. What's the next step in that process?
Well, after the labor license is coming out, it will seemingly go to national, although that's pretty much all they've done, but that's more formality that they have to realize and make sure it goes to national harbor, and then the casino is there to open as early as 2016. Table games and late night of last night, I forgot exactly. And then safety games get to start up at the casinos, but that would be very soon.
Yes,
three times in the last couple of days, which is pretty amazing, and it's brought up a lot of the other issues. And I think things that might have benefited from it, just because there was not the time and space and money for the opponents of same-sex marriage, which the supporters were so wary of, being that this happened in California and other places, to come in with late last-minute ad-libs. That didn't happen because the Smith gaming sucked all the air out of the room, as long as it told me, with all the issues in there.
Now, Patrick, in the district, Phil Mendelson won a special election to be D.C. Council Chairman. That sets up another special election to his council seat. How do you expect that race to shape up?
Right. If you like elections, you like easy politics, because it seems like we're having one every couple of months. This special election is going to happen in the spring, and we're probably going to see, maybe half a dozen, perhaps more, former people who have run for races throw their hat in the ring, because the biggest problem, the biggest hurdle for a challenger is name recognition, name ID, and the easiest way to overcome that is to run for a race. We're probably going to see a lot of former people who have run for office throw their hat in the ring for this open at-large seat, and that's going to happen in the spring when we'll be covering it.
Well, Michael, you can select in Virginia. Do you have such a plan statewide that Obama and Kennedy are launched differently at a little bit than you had expected?
Yeah, Northern Virginia actually played a decisive role in the growing demographics in Northern Virginia are being looked at very closely by parties, by Socialist parties. There were only about 100,000 votes that separated Obama and Romney last night. Obama had 1.9 million votes in Virginia. Romney had about 1.8. So one of the interesting things about that is that the third party candidates, one of whom was a former Virginia congressman, didn't seem to play all that much of a role at all. He had all the third party vote candidates together. That only equals about 50,000 votes, which is about half the margin difference.
And in Virginia, no House seats, U.S. House seats coming over. But in Maryland, Matt, John Delaney, the Democrat, did be the incumbent Republican, wants to Bartlett under the meeting regional district there. It looks like you're going to be a pretty wide margin to the end.